Right, on the previous episode of Lost on This Island.
Dun, dun.
Marcia, you're on recap duty.
Me?
Yep. You're the dwarven lore master.
We were trapped in the island. So... We survived the day. We killed the Pikachus, which gave us enough food for two more days. Even though we used a day, and we still have 2 days.
Yeah. All right. So, valiant.
Some people were boosting morale.
Okay, so.
Right.
Camp stats, you have 2 days of food left. You have, of your 5 survivors, Eris, Gellick, Jask, Ishiru, and Sasha, you have freed Gellick, who has become somewhat amicable. You can tell that he's definitely still mistrusting of you and not super, super friendly with you. Jask is pretty friendly with you. And you have tasked him with trying to make sure that everybody stays fed. And Gaelic is somewhat contributing to the party. And he's trying to get the rest of everybody out of their funks. Nobody else seems particularly able to contribute to camp survival at this point. Eris is grumpy from what you can tell from her being sick. She has some kind of a sickness, which you haven't...
I thought it was Sasha that was sick.
No, it was Eris. Eris is sick. Sasha is the one that's the, like... she is kind of scared... is still shaken up really bad. She is definitely frightened. Ishiru is a little bit out of it still. He's had very little to say. He is lost in his own world. Neither one of them seem like they're willing to take on any duties. And Eris, you can't really get a sense because something is wrong with her. So I want you guys to. We are going to start day 2.
So we did watch for the next night already.
Yes.
Or are we doing watch?
No, watch. What we handled watch yesterday or yestertime.
Okay. Nothing happened overnight this time.
Something did happen overnight this time. I need Retzram to give me a saving throw. I'm not sure which one yet because all the stuff I had already is gone. Fortitude save.
For who?
Retzram.
Critical fail.
Perfect.
Maybe one day I'll have a problem with 3.
Your bonus is so high, too.
All right. Cool.
I died in my sleep.
You did not die in your sleep.
Roll a new character.
But you wake up and you have something of a headache. It's not enough to hinder you in any way, but you're just, it's like, oh, this is going to be a rough day kind of a feeling. You think it may be that you haven't had enough fresh water.
I want to go ahead and... We're all awake right now, right?
Yeah, this is dawn of the second day. You guys are free to take whatever actions you want. On this day, there's plenty of island to explore. Jask is going to try and gather food pretty much all day from sunup to sundown.
We could explore.
And Gellick is going to keep working on morale, right?
He's gonna help with people. You're welcome
to
try. That
guy can make fresh water, right?
Yes, he can. He can create water.
The Jazz can create water.
Yes.
Yeah. I want to check in with Ares.
Okay. She is... she still looks sick, but you can tell that it's not any kind of lethal thing. In fact, give me a heal check. Any day. Doctor Overdose.
Oh, I meant to do that as Tygon. Why did that change my name to Doctor Overdose?
All right.
I don't know, but it was funny at the time.
I don't know.
My login name.
Oh, if you haven't set it, it just does that as your default.
Well, I had set it last week. It just changed it on me.
That was last week ago. She looks to be suffering from some kind of withdrawal symptoms. There is some kind of chemical that she needs.
Maybe Dr. Overdose can help her.
crack cocaine.
Does it look as a cleric? Can I see if it's maybe more alcohol or more tobacco or?
It looks to be extremely similar to hangovers, which you are not super familiar with on your own, since you are just supernaturally never having them, what with the constant flow of drink. But yeah, she is showing all the symptoms of a hangover.
So it's more like she just needs alcohol.
Yeah, and you think that whereas you have like a holy power that you draw through alcohol, she is more on the side of like literally an alcoholic.
Yeah, but you forgot. I said this at the beginning of our mission, that I was bringing a cask of my homemade ale, too. And I still have that.
Yeah, so if you wanted to present her some alcohol to maybe overcome some of her symptoms, that's...
Yes, I do. I want to sit down with her and take that out and be like, hey, this is my little secret that I have this. You look like you need it more than anybody else here. I don't want to keep it a secret from everyone else, but... I'd rather it be put towards good use, and we can't have people that aren't steady on their feet. And you look like you're needing this.
She gives you a really kind of undercut, kind of betrayed glare, but does not refuse what you are giving her.
Yay.
Give me a diplomacy check at +4.
Well, I have +10 already, so...
+4 on top of it. This is a circumstance bonus.
Woohoo! +10, +4.
Pow. 21.
And I want to say to her, listen, this is not enough to last us for what we might be here for a very long time. I can create supernatural alcohol, but it's probably not going to get you drunk. So we might need to wean you off this. I want to be very clear with her that we need everyone on their best footing.
She's all right. Well, I'll do what I can. I know you spent all day yesterday trying to organize things, what were going on, and I wasn't really paying attention because I had a splitting headache.
I get it. I've been there. It's been a while, but I've been there.
I can probably keep an eye out for whatever.
But you rest today. That's fine. But if you can help fortify camp just a little bit, maybe.
I'll stand guard.
Perfect.
Yeah.
And then I want to move on to Easter room.
Alright. Does anybody else want to speak?
Yeah, let someone else try to do something. I'm going on to Easter room next. While I was doing this, who was doing what?
I know Tygon has the make people feel better skills, but I don't want it to overshadow everybody else's intentions.
I don't have anything that I want to do with the other people. I was going to say, hey, I'm going to be fishing, and let me know if you want to go exploring. Otherwise, I'll be fishing.
I want to drink some water.
Are there any large mountain ranges in the area?
If we look around? So if you look toward the inland, there is a pretty high jungle that you're going to have to get through if you go more or less directly south. And judging by the beaches that you went on, so you can tell that the island mostly goes, there's really high terrain way off, you know, in the distance over here somewhere. But you'll have to cut through jungle if you want to go straight there. And also there are sandy beaches along either shore if you wanted to try and circumnavigate the island first. But that only works as far as you have beaches. But neither one looks more or less traversable. There is a high... If you look to your west... which is your right as you pass on the island, is your closest high point. Probably based on your survival skills, maybe 2 to 3 miles away. There's a bugbear.
Okay. You ready to read?
Go read.
Come on. Go books.
Says bye. I said I want to run on the shoreline. Maybe we'll find a way inland that's not so terrible as cutting through all that jungle.
Well, if you're actually exploring, I'll hand off the fishing nets to someone else.
Well, and where's the next island from here? Can we look across and see anything?
Not really.
So we're facing ocean. And we know ocean. We are in that inlet, right? So there should be inland further through a channel, right?
Right, but this map is on the scales of like dozens and dozens of miles.
Yeah. So we're down in Desperation Bay, right?
Right. But you may not be in it. I mean, you could be all the way out here somewhere.
All right. I would just go, if we took a raft, go east.
That's what I would look for. Not that it'd be any easier, like, if we hopped on a raft or something, but the mainland would at least have people.
Thinking of making a boat, when you look out to the wreck of the Genevieve, it's long gone. At some point through the night, it managed to tear loose from the cliff.
Yeah.
And there's nothing there anymore except for little pieces of the rowboat that was tethered to the rocks.
Yeah, we probably have to make something.
Value, didn't we?
Yeah. So yeah, I'd like to explore the shoreline to see if we can't see the actual landmass, or if we can't find a way further inland. Because if we get up on a high mountain, we should be able to see, right? A little better.
Yeah, if you want to go to a high point, you'll want to go directly, directly west.
Okay. Well, that's up to you guys. Do you guys want to cut inland or do you want to try going west?
Like, I don't know if you can see on here, but this map is slightly topographic. So.
Well, all we can see is the top two corners.
Yeah. No, no. Even on the second spot, you can tell that there's like a cliff face here that, you know, what you climb down to get to the ship. And then there's like a plain area here, and then it starts to climb up rather sharply before it hits the jungle line.
I'm probably going to focus on working on water and food again today after I've finished motivating people. So whatever you want to do, if you want to go explore.
Yeah, let's let Durhood go off by himself.
Yeah.
Who else is going exploring? Restram?
Sergio's going.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Tygon, you're bygone.
I just don't get into trouble. I want to make sure we have enough food and water.
Okay. Do you guys want to head west exploring party?
I thought heading east means we would go along the coast and possibly get closer to a good view of any land to the east over the, you know, over the sea.
So, out this way?
Hang on.
Yeah, I thought that's a... Well, besides the bug there.
Do you want to go right or left?
I was going to say right. I was talking about this right here.
Yeah, okay, let's do it.
All right, we'll go right.
Let's clear out another square.
And we're going to follow the coastline mostly?
Yes.
All right. Tygon, they're making preparations to do a trek expedition. I think all of you guys have your own rations and stuff on you, right?
A trek expedition, yeah.
The 2 days you have is the supplies that you got off of the Genevieve. None of that is counting the trail rations and such you had on your person. So Tygon, you slip up to Ishiro, who has done he spent his morning ritual sharpening this super weaponese-looking katana, and he does some like bowing in front of it, all kinds of things that are really exotic and foreign to you. He doesn't acknowledge you making your presence felt.
Where are the yellow dinosaurs? Is he doing what he did yesterday, just sitting and staring at the ocean?
He probably will start doing that later on. It looks like he's going through like a routine.
I don't want to interrupt his routine, so I just kind of stand at a distance safely, like close enough that he acknowledges that I'm there, but like not interrupting like his routine and his ritual. How many are there? And I just kind of just wait until he's done. He seems like he's done.
Okay.
Being as respectful as I possibly can.
All right, he does do that, and then he, you know, sheathes the sword, and he gets one of the little water skins that Jask has been making, and he just goes down to the beach, and he sits and he stares out at it again.
I go and I sit next to him. Does he seem as afraid as he was the day before?
Yeah, you can tell that he still doesn't seem to be on top of the situation yet.
And where are the trees?
I say, you know, it's not hopeless here. Beautiful, beautiful wilderness. It's dangerous, but beautiful. And I believe that our faith, our rituals, and our skills will get us through here. I want to know, I don't even know if you speak common, but I want to know if you can help.
All right, make a diplomacy check.
Hey, Marsha.
Any pluses?
Mute your mic when you're not speaking. I hear the background voices.
Yeah.
Try to listen.
Put tape over your child and...
No.
Thank you so much.
I am. Do I get any pluses?
Your default ones.
Okay. Not terrible.
Not terrible.
Any response?
Yeah. He says, yes, I can understand you. But I still think it is hopeless and we are lost on this island forever. Even if we survive, it's no life worth living.
Who says we're going to be stuck on this island forever? With our skills, we can get off one way or another. Today, my friends are going to explore. I'm going to make sure we have food and water. Tonight I'll make alcohol from the gods, and we will rejoice that we have lived another day. Is not every day worth living?
I've lived a long time, and I question that more and more.
But wouldn't you rather die in glory?
No, glory is for those who are foolish at heart. But I will do what I can for you. What task would you set me upon?
What task can you do? I don't know any of your skills. What do you think you're best at or good at?
I can fight. I can also try and fortify our defenses here.
Perfect. Fortify our defenses. Perfect.
All right.
We have Ares is guarding. She's working as a guard. If you fortify and make some traps around the base, that's great. Jask is going to get us some food.
All right, everybody's got a job to do that is willing to do it now, except for Sasha.
That's my next person I want to talk to before I'm going to go off on my goal for the day, which is going to be getting food as well, getting food and water.
All right, neat. So, yeah, she is not even getting out of bed at this. Like, yesterday she spent the whole time just in bed kind of crying. And she looks to be that she's going to keep doing the same thing again. She's not even really getting up much at all. It looks like she maybe she can sleep through this whole ordeal and will wake up. We'll wake up and it'll all be over.
I come sit down next to her. I give her water, make sure that she has the water that Jax has been making. And I say very quietly, hope is not lost. The gods are with us. We have water. We have food. We're making more water and more food every day. We have people exploring. We'll be off this island in a week. Nothing to fear. But we can use all the help we can get. I'd like to know that you stand by us.
Okay. Make a diplomacy check at -2. Ooh.
Oh! That's pretty darn good.
You're very diplomatic.
I am very diplomatic. As I like to say, I am diplomatic as fuck.
If you were a robot, you'd be Diplomaticon.
There you go.
All right. She, you know, the first time she ever meets you face to face, she looks at you and you can tell she's been crying all night. Her face is all puffy. And she says, you don't understand how much danger we're in. Did you not hear the creatures howling through the night? And that, I saw you unchain that man, Jask. He could be a murderer, or he could be a criminal.
He could. But right now, he's helping us.
Well,
he is doing a lot to help us. And I have killed beasts far worse than what you may think. Let me tell you about this time I killed a minotaur. That was pretty impressive. It was trying to kill a friend of mine, and I was just got like right in there and jab, jab, jab with my rapier, and it was dead. Good times. You have nothing to fear with us.
Well, I'm not looking to gain any more enemies. I'll
then seek to gain friends instead.
Hey, you're not the boss of me. Look, I'll help, but don't you tell me what to do.
I'm not telling. I'm only asking to be your friend.
All right. She gets up and she tries to dust herself off from all the tears, and you can tell that she is shaky when she takes steps. She's kind of shivering a little bit, even that bad. But she picks up a scimitar and, you know, puts it in a holster, a sheath. Not a scimitar, a rapier. She's got a rapier on one side and a kukri on the other. And she strolls out into the camp trying to look to serve some kind of a purpose.
Does she kind of seem like she knows what she's going to do to try to help, or does she need guidance?
Well, judging by the way she handles these blades, she could probably do some, you know, defending, the same thing that Eris is doing. or actually, probably, I don't know, she's kind of hard to tell. You can tell that she, yeah, I don't know, you may want to ask her. She seems somewhat physical.
Sasha, what skills do you have can help assist us here? I don't know what you can do, so I want to help you. We need to get this campsite going.
I can... Well, she looks around and sees that you're really low on food supplies just from the stuff you salvaged, and she says that I can hunt. I can keep us fed for days, all of us.
That's fantastic. Cool. Hearing that, I'm like, you're in charge of hunting. And at this point, we got everybody in camp doing something to help further camp. I go to the people before they set out and say, I'm with you, I'll join you.
They're already like, you know, a mile ahead of you.
I'm like,
they didn't wait around for this garbage.
Because Gaelic is working on morale. Jask is hunting in water. We got guard. We got defenses.
We're doing good.
Yeah, between the five obvious roles, you have all six people working on them, and the two that seem or the one that seems the most critical being food is the one that's pulling double duty.
Yeah,
good.
Although you can't really feel like you can trust Sasha right now because she may have another panic attack.
I trust her.
Not that you don't trust her to betray you. You don't trust her to like. Not freak out.
Panic.
Yeah.
I want to, if they're going off, before they leave, because they're guessing before they left ahead of me, I want to ask if they're coming back tonight or if they're going to keep exploring.
I don't know. What do you say, adventurers?
Sergio?
Repeat the question, I'm sorry.
Are y'all going to keep exploring into tomorrow, or are y'all just going to explore as far as you can out today and then come back?
I would say today. No, I would not stay out there nighttime. Anyway.
Okay, then I hurry to catch up to them as well.
Okay.
All right. So,
the more the merrier. Let's do it.
It's relatively easy to move along the beach because you're not... you know, traipsing through jungle. Let's see here. So it so every single one of these hexes, assuming you're not on a road or something, and even on the beaches, it's still kind of relatively tough to travel because the beaches are somewhat thin in places, takes about 2 hours. And you'll figure that out when we move to the first one over here.
Do you guys want to keep traveling until we have to go to sleep, or do you want to travel half a day and then come back?
Half the day and then come back.
Yeah, we talked about it half the day.
And just so we're clear, you probably spent about 2 hours in the camp just prepping to make this trip, doing your conversating with everybody else, making sure everybody was aware of things. And let's reveal a new hex.
Things and stuff.
More coastline. But you can see that you are so you're on the northern edge of this coastline. And at the top of this relatively steep cliff is just jungle hanging over the edge forever. And you see lots of all kinds of birds and things. And occasionally off in the distance, you see, like, I say off in the distance, but you see these huge-looking birds don't seem to have a lot of plumage on them, just coming out of the jungle in places ahead of you and swooping around. They look like pterodactyls. Also, you have a better view of this coastline over here. And you can see that there is an island over there with a big shipwreck and just kind of moored on it.
Do we want
to go? What is the scale of that island? How big is the shipwreck in proportion to that island?
It's just kind of wedged on one side of it.
Does it look like it's possible to get to it, or is it too far out in the water?
So it looks like it would be not an impossible swim, but maybe it would take, you know, it'd probably take like an hour to swim out there.
And then to get stuff back would be a pain.
Yeah. But if you wanted to make like a small time raft, that's probably pretty easy to do.
How long would it take to make a raft?
Depends on your survival skill.
Do y'all want to try to get over to there and forage for stuff? This might be the ship that Jask mentioned of the other people that may be on this island. Yeah. I vaguely remember that.
How long do you guys think it'll take us to get there?
An hour to swim.
I think if you built a raft and then tried to, you know, navigate it over there through the surf, which is not super dangerous right now, probably about 2 hours.
Let's build a raft.
We can do that, but let's make sure and not stay too long. We don't want to get caught out in the dark after.
Do we remember the name of the boat that Jask mentioned?
He told you to be on the lookout for something called the Brine Demon.
All right.
20 plus. Survival to build a raft?
Yeah, go ahead.
Anybody else going to help me with this?
Yeah, are we all making our own rolls or just like...
Yeah, we all make a survival roll to build a raft.
Yeah, everybody can aid.
Well, aid is aiding a roll or is aiding just saying we're aiding?
Yes, it is both of those things. You say, I am going to aid you, and you make a survival check, and you have to beat a 10. If you beat a 10, it gets a plus 2. So Marcia keeps... Durhood keeps bringing all these like twigs, and she's like, "I found some wood, guys."
I'm helping.
Yeah, the only two people here who know how to build a raft are Restram and Sergio.
Yeah, Restram, you see Tygon just like grabbing sticks and just like bundling together, and you realize that he is going to doom you all.
I start throwing sticks into the ocean.
That's not how you boat.
If you guys want to start over and try again, that seems pretty feasible.
Here, let me do it. Restram, get me that stick. No, not that stick, that stick.
All right, Sergio, yeah, make a Restram, you're like...
Make the stick, right?
Survival check?
Yeah, make a survival check.
Marcia. Make another survival check, Marcia.
Nay.
Yeah, that'll take it over 10 for me.
All right, so
worked 11, I guess.
I'm like lucky with Shakespeare.
Yeah, it is taking you guys somewhat longer than you would like to do this. And because of that, you realize you may want to take a break. It gets kind of overbearingly hot. When you were in the little beachhead area where there was a little bit of pier, it seems somewhat cooler, but out here on the beach, you're just like, you know, in the hardcore exposed sunlight. So right here, it's okay, but if you get into like the steamy jungles without a big ocean breeze to cool you down, you can tell that it might be something to be aware of is hot temperature. But you get a raft built in the late afternoon. You may want to, you know, do some.
Yeah, how long would it take to get back to camp from here?
You have traveled for 4 hours at this point. You have spent 4 hours in your day.
We could leave the raft here and
come back in the morning.
Actually,
and try
use it tomorrow. It.
Yeah.
I mean, half of that time was just building a raft.
right. We'll have a raft ready to go tomorrow.
But the raft's built now, so if we come here first thing in the morning after getting camp settled, go over there, and maybe bring Jask with us, since he might recognize the boat.
Okay, so we'll travel back.
And I want to make sure everybody agrees with that first before we commit to that.
Yeah, I mean, I don't want to camp out in the field.
Yeah, let's go back to the camp. So we get back 4 hours later. It's probably just about getting dark.
Well, it only takes 2 hours to travel, so you get back. It is not even quite dusk yet. Restram, your headache has not gotten any better. Jask and Sasha aren't anywhere to be found. Gaelic tells you that they are in the jungle hunting, that Sasha took the initiative.
Perfect.
Mm.
Is camp looking more stable, better?
Yeah, Ishiru is setting out a bunch of, he's found, you know, pieces of metal, like pots and pans and tins and things. He may have pilfered some of your cookware from your packs that you have. But he set out a bunch of lines that if they are tripped, they won't do any damage or anything, but they're going to make a whole bunch of noise. And you see that he has also started to collect raw materials to make big spikes out of.
Nice. Is there enough time for me to fish a little bit before the end of the day?
Yeah, you guys still have... You have about 2 hours left of daylight, so yes.
Do I need to make more survival?
Yeah.
I need to fish too.
Is my barrel of ale anywhere near me?
It's at the camp. You've pointed out to her what the ale is if she ever feels the need.
But because I want to see where it is and see if she's drank any of it. Is basically what I'm saying.
Yes, but not any more than you would be surprised by.
I want to do this without her noticing. I want to kind of water it down with my fake alcohol, with the created alcohol.
Water it up.
Because I just in case, because I'm trying to wean her off of it. So if it's a little watery, she won't notice it because it still tastes like alcohol. All
right.
And I want to taste like the really good strong stuff, the alcohol I make and put in it. Without her noticing, of course.
All right. I need to do some dice rolls here. Hold on a second.
Say, give this not a hand check.
My dexterity is not high. I'm more likely to fall flat on my face when trying to do any dex checks.
Somehow you managed to slit your own throat doing sleight of hand.
I was just doing a card trick, and then I just started bleeding out everywhere.
Oh, man. Hold on. It's a lot of systems in play here. Plus two. Okay, neat. So you guys are fishing. Around dusk, you see there is a big commotion at the jungle line.
I want to go out towards it as quickly as I can.
You start heading up, you get your arms, you run toward that direction to see what's going on, and you see Sasha, who has a big goat like wrapped over her shoulders with like an arrow sticking out of it, running as fast as you can, Jask behind her. And they are running at breakneck speed from something in the jungle.
Got my bow and arrow ready.
All right, let's roll initiative.
Do you want us to roll, or are you going to roll?
You can roll it. Let me just turn the initiative counter on. I'm going to get as much mileage out of this map as I can. So let's delete
this. Remember, I had low dexterity? Yeah, that affects my initiative roll. Ein.
She's playful. You can tell that she's part outdoor cat.
Yes. Yeah, I'm catching mice.
And everyone should have full health, and I need full...
Yeah, everybody should be at full health. You guys make sure that your new hit point totals are in there. Tygon, you didn't pick your token first. Oh, you didn't even do the initiative thing.
I did. I don't have that thing in there. I don't think I have my character updated properly in this thing.
You should
I do. Did... manually.
How many HP do I have?
Oh, there, I did the initiative thing. Oh, yeah, I had to do it right. I got one more than I did. That D20 minus one was my initiative roll.
Ken didn't do it either. You have to click your token first.
There we go.
Retsram knows what's up. Durhood knows what's up.
Why does Durhood have a death symbol on him?
Because I'm going to kill him.
Because I'm going to kill him. I don't know. The symbols are for you guys.
I actually just didn't know they were there.
Look, it's a cat.
Kitty cat.
I don't believe in cats.
Probably good. Seems like a good life choice. So,
what do you do? You
see turn order? How do I add myself to turn order?
You can't.
You do it. Okay.
Yeah, if you have your token selected, when you roll the initiative button, it does it automatically. But
oh, okay. My bad.
And this guy's initiative. I'm really slow about this. This would be easier if you guys would just show up at my house. Can you do that, please?
I could start
on my way.
I could head out now and I might be there. Next next month?
I'll be over there in 10 hours.
I got space. I mean, big bed. All right, so Sasha and...
Why am I in the water?
Because you were fishing. You fly fish.
Hmm. Fish flying.
So the Sasha and Jask just, run past you guys. And Sasha's kind of giggling about it. You get the sense that she is enjoying whatever is chasing you guys. Jask is just like, those things hurt. Be careful. I don't.
I kind of laugh as I hear her giggling. Sounds like someone's in a better mood.
And a big old Pikachu, one of these things, comes running out of the jungle.
Oh, another Pikachu.
Another Pikachu. Apparently they're all over the
just
place
one.
Here. You only see one that come out of the jungle for now.
Spread out. He's got an area of effect. Everybody spread out.
It runs up to the nearest person, which is Sergio.
I spread out.
And it tries to shock you.
No.
So give me a reflex save. Save, so you take 1 point of non-lethal damage as it sends a shock to you.
Alright.
And Durhud, you're up.
I cast Force Screen.
Cool. You want to do anything else?
That's it?
That's it. I'm going to keep fishing. Restram.
Keep fishing.
Yeah, I guess there. I also have to tackle him now.
You gonna murder it? You do not want to play around with these things, do you? 18 will hit.
It's the highest I rolled on it. And I rolled like a 15, but it didn't matter.
Oh my gosh. Thing puts on the brakes. Sergio?
Well, he came right up to me, but I still have a bow and arrow, so I guess I'm going to do a point blank shot, which gives me plus one, I think.
Well, whenever you're within 30 feet, you have a point blank shot.
Yeah, plus one to hit and damage. 1 second, I'll make the roll.
Right.
10 plus one is 11.
You miss, and it's going to try and bite you.
Okay.
With a 14 to hit.
Okay. Oh, 1 second. Oh, I rolled a 4. I guess the dex bonus is there. I'm sorry. What was the hit roll?
14 to bite you.
Oh, well, I am AC 17, so. No.
Okay. Tygon.
I'm going to move down 10 feet and then behind him so as not to like get in that 5 feet square and kind of block him off from behind.
Juking.
So as not to like step in and then move. And then I'm going to stab him with my rapier. Poke, poke, poke. Oh, come on.
Is you now? 20 will hit.
Oh, come on.
Holy smokes.
All wait, right. No, I did that wrong. That's not right. It's not plus four, it's plus one. So I only did 3 points of damage.
Okay. Well,
I just hit a button.
He is hurting pretty bad. Did not realize he was running into an ambush.
He wasn't. You just happened to be chasing the wrong people.
And it doesn't want to deal with this at all anymore, so it is going to withdraw as a full action.
Catch him.
It's
going to attack my opportunity, though.
Tygon will be able to get one, but nobody else will.
Why won't nobody else? Everyone's within 5 feet.
But he is making a withdraw action. The first square doesn't count, so this square does. So Tygon can try and finish him off and blow it. And it's gonna spend the rest of its turn running into the jungle. Good luck catching it.
I'd like to take a final pot shot with my bow and arrow.
Let's stay in initiative then.
All
right. Durhud, it ran off. It was terrified of your force screen.
I enjoyed being force screen. For another 3 minutes.
Ain't no fish gonna bite my toes. Retzerm.
I raise my arms above my head and just yell.
All right. Sergio wants to make a pot shot at it. Give me a perception check.
All right. Scroll down. Perception. Here we go. Not very perceptive.
It has a plus 17 to stealth in dense foliage, so it is gone.
How far away is it?
It, as soon as it gets off the map, it is in basically like jungle terrain. So regardless of how far it is, it's got a plus 17 to its stealth in undergrowth.
But how far is it?
For spiritual weapon purposes?
I got spells that don't have attack rolls. I just hit.
What are those spells?
I'm trying to find them. I just remember I have them.
But no, Sergio, you try and find it, and it's you would be shooting blind at this point.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
So unless you guys are super murder rampagey, it's gonna get away. Perry wants
to spells to look through.
I am super uninterested in chasing a shocker lizard.
I could do a hold person.
It's that not a person.
Is it a humanoid creature?
Nope.
Damn, I didn't realize it didn't work against animals.
It's called person. You only think they're people.
No, it does work against creatures, because it very specifically talks about effects on winged creatures, too.
Well, yeah, winged creatures that are humanoids. All humanoids are creatures, but not all creatures are humanoids. Marcia, you look like you're having too much fun. Is that a bear? I got beer, but I don't want to put pants on.
Okay,
usually,
fine.
I usually don't get that point after I drink the beer.
I turn to Sasha and Jazz and say, y'all all right?
Sasha laughs and says, yeah, oops. Seems like there's clutches of those things all over the place out here, and I just wanted to grab some eggs, and Mama didn't like that so much. And Jessica's like, I told her not to leave them be. I saw what they did yesterday.
Well, did you get any eggs?
Well, no, but, I mean, it's worth a shot.
Next
I got
time
this, and she... So, okay, she's like, I got this, and she unhurls... this goat. She has slain a goat.
Tight.
Nice. Good job, hunting team.
And yeah, Jask is like, and then he pulls out a bunch of berries and things that he's foraged together.
Jask, I don't think we need you to hunt anymore.
So you guys are survivalists. So, how many of you are there? There's 9 of you?
I don't know. You told me.
Well, yeah, there's 4.
I'm bad at numbers.
You're bad at numbers. Math is hard. Between the two of them, and this is, you know, fresh food that you have no way to really store or skin or smoke and whatnot, plus goats aren't really that much meat, honestly, relatively, for a bunch of hungry dwarves and adventurers. They have gathered enough food for probably 2 more days.
Wonderful.
So you lose,
but it's a lot of food, so we can kind of like have a feast. It just goes bad quickly.
Yeah, so you're going to be -1 food for today and then +2 food for tomorrow. So you will begin day 3 with 3 days worth of food.
Huzzah. And tonight I want to like make sure like we eat hearty, and I want to make like alcohol and encourage Gaelic to like make good music, so we're kind of relaxing and being festive almost.
He gets into it.
An adventure. And I want to pull Jask aside.
Yo.
And be like, we came across a ship when exploring. We couldn't get close enough to identify it. But do you have any markers of the ship you mentioned that might help us see if it's the same ship?
Well, it should have the brine demon emblazoned on it somewhere. Maybe if not on the ship, then in the record books itself. It was captained by a man named Averett Kincarion. So anything with his name on it if you can't find the brine demon might be shipwrecked.
And then I want to be like, are you feeling okay? I know you didn't catch much hunting today.
What are you talking about? I got all these nuts and berries and grains and things.
And she got to go.
Half of this food here is Jask's. You guys aren't carnivores. He carried his fair weight, but yeah, he is offended by your, you know, not being excited about.
I'm just like, you feel like there's a better place we could use you. I want to make sure we're using you to your best of your abilities. We might not need two people hunting.
What? Yeah, we do.
Two people.
For safety.
I want to see what it says.
And,
absolutely, they just keep on doing this. This was good, and no one died, which is the most important part.
There's probably hundreds of shipwrecks here. Let me make a diplomacy check. You're asking him to do something he's not super keen on doing.
I'm trying to get his feeling for what he feels he's good at doing.
Yeah, he already knows what he's good at doing, but you're wanting him to be comfortable with this ship, which is not a you're asking.
No, I
was
asking to pay for the ship. I wasn't asking him to look for a ship. I was asking information. I asked him if there's other tasks other than hunting he feels he's qualified to do.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Medic generally.
Do we need a medic?
Just in case.
This isn't Survivor. We don't have to vote someone off the island.
No, I'm just saying. You're not. He's better suited as a medic or as a hunter. I think Sasha is going to be a really good hunter.
The benefits of having someone dedicating to being a medic is you guys will recover natural hit points faster, which won't matter because you have a cleric and he can channel energy like crazy. But also
I want to make sure to channel all my energies every night before I go to bed.
He is, that's a super dangerous idea. Having a medic will also help with,
zombie goats
dealing with, making sure that the fire is kept. And the reason that's a medic based thing is it's going to stave off bugs, which are disease vectors. Also he is going to be on a lookout for, mundane injuries and things.
I mean, I don't
psychological like well-being. Will he be our shrink?
No, that's what Gaelic's doing.
Yeah. I want to use half my daily charge of energy to positive energy to camp. Okay. Whether that's healing minor wounds or whatever.
Everybody's positive. Yeah, you don't think nobody really has hit point damage, and hit point damage isn't the real big danger here. It's, you know, starvation and thirst and disease. Also, I mean, living here forever could become your potential destinies. Who wants that? But yeah, he says that if you want me to go, you know, explore these ships with you, I'll consider it. But
no,
I think
you think you would be a decent medic and make sure we have water. You seem very astute at that.
No problem.
We already have infinite water.
He's the one who's been making our water.
Yeah. He can do that forever.
Oh, I thought you were doing that, mister.
No, I can make alcohol. He makes water.
Oh, right.
I like how a druid just kind of shits on this campaign.
I like having a two-person hunting group, though. Like, that is far more safe.
Well, we can try him working on that based on how things play out and if we become food shortaged. Because 3 days worth of food is...
We got plenty of food for the next two or three days. So I'd really be really interested, because you have a headache.
If I don't want to send Sasha out on her own, at the very least, reeks of, and then Sasha never came back.
Fair enough. Let's keep him as a hunter for now.
Okay. All right.
If you want to stay in camp until we see more food, that's cool. But having Sasha go on her own even more than... Like, I barely went out of town, almost died of shocker lizards.
Yeah, you're right. That's a bad idea.
Okay. I agree. Keep Jask and Sasha as a team hunting. Forget I said anything.
It was a valid conversation.
It's retcon.
Yeah, is there, no way to have people on defense in camp? Like, just even shittily attempt to keep the fire going?
Yes. But, the dealing with disease is not something that they're super trained in, so this is just he can make heal checks to basically reduce your infection rate. It's to make it as mechanical as possible.
Right. Well, actually, hey, Jask. Something's wrong with me.
You didn't ask me. You asked him. Okay. Not offended.
Well, I think he's... I think he just give a little checkup regardless of his current.
He will place his hands on your face and feel you over. And he will make a heal check. Here comes. Roll skill. Heal. Very good. He says you have a low grade fever. Which might not be dangerous unless it gets worse tomorrow. Let me keep an eye on you tonight.
Oh, baby.
Yeah, he's like, I'm going to try and find... some of the things I picked out there might do you some favors. I'm going to make you some tea. Also, Jared is a robot. Yeah, he's a robot specifically only when we play. When we're not playing, it's fine. And when we're in the pregame, it's fine. But as soon as the stream starts, he turns into a robot.
Yeah. Yes, I'm gonna go and tell people we're all not robots.
Robot house,
you're a robot.
Right?
Hey.
So, how much salvageable wood did it look like there was on the wreck?
You got all of it already.
Oh, we did. That's right.
But we didn't with the new wreck.
The new wreck.
Right. You're not sure. It looks like the majority of the boat is still there, but it could be centuries old and useless.
So we don't know yet. Until
at least we have fire.
Yeah, you could use it as for flames. You could light the whole thing on fire as a bonfire, as a signal, maybe.
Smoke signal.
Ooh, actually, that's not a bad idea.
Not to give you guys ideas. Not to feed you guys stuff or anything. You know, whatever.
Now that's almost feels like metagaming if we use that.
Yeah, I spoiled it. All right.
Empty out the entire boat and then just throw a few alchemist fires in it.
It just brings a bunch of prepared pterodactyls down on us.
Yeah. That would be our life. No. We there's a living statue inside the boat.
No. Stop. Triggered.
I could change my character name to Tuvok. Or was it Turok? Yeah, that dinosaur.
Yes.
Turok.
All right, so Ishiro and let's see here. Ishiro has been spending all the day making up trip lines and concealed spike pits, which he warns you all about, so that you don't accidentally set them off or anything. So that you can probably sleep a little bit easier.
I want to pull Gaelic aside a little bit and ask him about morale in the camp, how he feels it's going, how he's feeling, everything.
He seems to be doing a lot better himself. He says, Jask is as bright as ever. Sasha is hard to tell. She varies wildly between, being utterly terrified at the doom that's in store for you and these phases of ecstatic excitement to, go out and kill something.
Bipolar. Got it.
Ishiru seems to still be somewhat shaken and, Eris is, still kind of obviously sick. but Gaelic and Jas seem like that they're ready to do things. And you know, Gaelic, he was always kind of snide earlier, but you can tell that that hard edge is pretty much worn off over the past couple of days.
Yeah, we're getting in the groove. All right.
And that's good because he's our morale officer. He's helping other people get in better shape.
And so. he confesses that every now and then when people are down in the dumps, he gives up on them a little too easily, and it's probably not doing them in any favors. But all right, 9 o'clock. 9 o'clock break. Oh, love.
I'm gonna
need to drink. As I canned him an ale, and I hand some other people ales. Magical ales. I say, Gaelic, sing us a song about rescue. A jaunty tune, perhaps.
Let's see here.
And this is me putting you in the spot that you have to sing for us now, Adam.
Well, unfortunately, I don't have any instruments, and I don't sing. I'm more of what you would call a yes and performer.
Oh.
And my best routines from let's get those drinks coming.
Hand him an ale. I don't tell him that it's magical and it won't make him drunk, but I hand him an ale. And I kind of laugh a little bit and just kind of pat him on the back.
Yeah, I'm out of practice. I've been a little grumpy, and not having a bed is really working somewhat on my finery.
I understand that. Good bed with a good woman in it, just what we all need.
All right, so, well, shit.
Is mic out completely?
Your mic's out forever. I cannot join the voice chat. What, is it just like, say, can you hear us? Nope. My attempts to fix only broke. Nothing.
Anybody interesting saying anything interesting in the chat room, Adam?
Intox doing his normal Intox business. Hey, Intox. My number one fan. Doesn't have time to play, but he's always here during the entire game. Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to Marsha's house.
Thanks.
What's your name? I'm Tygon. You don't have to give your real name. What's your name?
Oh, I don't know yet. I'm just here.
You don't know yet? You don't know your name?
She's gonna be the post 9 p.m. player. It's like a vampire.
Are you gonna play Durhan now?
Ben's gone too. Everybody left. Nobody loves you.
Girls changed. Zach can't get an audio. Huh?
Hello, my darling.
How fun.
Oh shit. Oh my god.
That's what laps are for.
There he is.
Hey. We had a whole conversation about you that you didn't hear.
Oh, what was that?
We didn't really.
No, it's good. It was all good.
They were saying terrible.
I want people to talk about me. When they don't talk about me, I'm like, oh.
I don't trust people talking about me.
I'll take first watch tonight.
Talk about me more.
Oh, yeah, I was doing
it. It's on second.
I was doing the watch stuff.
Third.
These guys are totally... So, Jask and Gaelic are cool with taking watches also.
So oh, really?
If we have enough people splitting up watches, watches are only like an hour long.
Yeah.
That's awesome, though.
That's perfect, because we all get lots of sleep. Keeps us all rested.
We lost Redson?
Yeah, he's having mic issues.
He's trying. Well, it's not mic issues. He's having roll 20 issues. If he can't get back...
Okay.
So, there's the four of us each taking a watch, and then two other people taking watches. That's six watches. That's... If everyone takes like an hour and a half, we've got a full night there.
All right, let's see here.
Anything? We notice anything on any of our watches?
A whole lot of nope. Morning comes, nothing special.
Yay.
I want to check in real quickly with everyone, just make sure everyone's okay.
Oh, yeah, I got to do that again.
But I'm not, like, focused on spending time with them this morning. I'm just like, hey, you good? Hey, you good? Hey, you good? You need anything? You need anything?
So, one of the things that you do notice, Tygon, because you wanted to make a point of it yesterday, is that you put some pieces together and you figure that Eris, during the night, probably went to that jug of ale more often than you would have liked.
But I watered it down a little bit, didn't I?
You did, but maybe she's picked up on this. And it's not a sickness thing, but her mood has soured.
She's staying hydrated. That's the important thing.
Yeah, she is still willing to, you know, do her duties, but she is somewhat more gruff about it. And she plays it off as being, you know, it's just like the realness of it is finally hitting her now that she's thinking with a clear head.
I didn't water it down much. There wasn't much room in the cask to add fake alcohol to it. But, I mean, she doesn't look like hungover anymore, right?
No, but you can tell that she is
not happy with me.
She is an alcoholic at heart. Like, she is always going to be. If she's not sick from a hangover, she is sick from booze. So she needs to get cured.
So it definitely looks like it's the alcohol, though. It doesn't look like some sort of communicable disease.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. That is for sure. So Ishiro spent all day yesterday setting up all these traps. And he actually seems to have worked himself a little poorly. Sasha is doing a lot better now that she has a job to do that she is capable at and really good at. But she, you know, you can tell that she is still a little timid. But Ishiro seems like he may be like neurotically defending. Making all these traps and stuff because he's like, I have to, you know, every hour of the sun is up. I have to get to work because there's no telling what's in this jungle.
I think that's his Japanese work ethic.
Yeah, well, Japan? Yeah, he has gotten a little bit less on the morale train. He's going downhill.
I want to check in on him and be like, good job with all the traps. Does he want to spruce up camp a little bit better today? Maybe.
Your coping mechanism is freaking everybody out, man.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm like, the traps look really nice.
Diplomacy.
Let's make ourselves a little more comfortable. Can you help with that, maybe? I don't know if that's in your skill set.
Well, yeah. It's like, yeah, but if once they get to the camp, it's too late. They'll be honest. I mean, what good are the defenses? What good is defense?
if you want to do more defenses, feel free. I kind of pat him on the back and be like, don't run yourself ragged. We need to stay healthy.
Yeah, you can tell that he is somewhat frightened of everything going on.
And I kind of just like kind of encourage him and try to help him, you know, chill, man. We got this. We just need to be calm.
Go for them diplomacy checks.
Any bonus this time?
No. All right, he kind of lets out this deep, heavy sigh, and says, "You truly are looking out for us."
I am. I really am. I want us all to make it off this island alive.
Said very well. I will be more calm. I will center myself.
Anything you need, let me know. We got a team here. We got to work together. We can do this together.
Well, I looked out to the sea so often because this island is notorious as a pirate's den, and I was expecting a crew of brigands or something to bear down on us at any moment and just slaughter us all wholesale. That's partly why I was so anxious to put our defenses up yesterday, because at least I would have one less side to be worried about.
And as you continue to build defenses, we will continue to protect each other. And I kind of reach out my hand as like, shake my hand and be like, together we will be surviving. If they do come and attack us, they aren't just fighting one of us. They have to make it through all of us. We are together.
Well, a full pirate ship will maybe be more than a match for us, but if we can get off this island before they arrive, maybe we can, maybe with what legendary treasures lie here, we can keep for ourselves.
Maybe. I like the way you think.
I've heard rumors of a treasure pit on this island. I was keeping it to myself, but
treasure pit.
If we find, hey, let me tell you this: if we find it, you get first dibs on your piece of treasure. I'm gonna want my share. Everyone's gonna want their fair share, but I'll let you take first dibs if there's something shiny.
He produces a scroll.
Oh, yes. You got a map.
And he unfurls it, and he has a hand-drawn map of the island.
Yes.
Yeah.
And it doesn't bear details. The whole thing looks like a big crescent sea with like the bottom part of the sea is more landmass. But there is an X marking a spot on it, which is several, based on your estimates, several miles, several days' journey southeast, up on top of a hill.
So if that's something we go to, it's like we're taking a couple days to go get that.
And it might be best to entrench the rest of the party staying behind further into the jungle if there are pirates searching the coastline. That way our camp wouldn't just be right there on the coastline.
But inside the jungle, we might encounter more Pikachus and other threats, and it's going to be hotter without the coastal wind.
Yeah, I'm thinking we would take a small party if we were going to investigate this and leave the civilians behind.
I think if we all go together, we're going to be best.
So I'm going to try and make this visible on the big map, but I gotta do it carefully. So hold on a second.
I think our best bet, however, is to go check out that ship and see what we can't find on that ship today. And if we're going to start doing that tomorrow. Although, I'm starting to think that everyone's going to have their own... this is out of character. I'm starting to think that everyone is going to have their own little thing on this island we could maybe get. Jask has a ship he wants us to find. Ishu has a treasure.
That's ludicrous. I don't know what you're talking about.
I think everyone might have an objective. And I kind of want to do them all because that's the way I play games. Oh, you have a side quest for me? Oh, you have a side quest for me? Oh, you have a side quest for me? Okay.
Everyone has a side quest for you.
Oh, we'll get off this island eventually. Let me just explore every inch of it and get every little piece of magical item off of it first.
I reset and it's still broke.
Maybe you're broke. Wait, he can't hear me, right?
He can hear you.
Oh. You're not broke.
All right, let's So you guys go to the hangout and let him know what's going on with Hishiru. I am going to get this. I want to mark on the big map where this place is. I'm just going to find it because it's also all hidden from me.
The hangout. How do I get on the hangout?
The Google Hangout. I'll start a call. All right, so everybody go to Roll 20 options, my settings, and say that you want to broadcast to others. Nothing. Just turn that off.
Oh, we are moving video and finally hangouts?
Yeah, we're just going to go to hangouts. And then I'm going to start the hangout up.
Hello.
Hey.
Is the thing.
All right.
Mushy mushy.
Hello.
Hello?
Hello.
I can't really hear y'all.
Hello.
Hello. I mean, I can hear you, just really, really quiet.
Well, turn your volume up.
I have to crank my volume now.
The only benefit of this is that we're gonna lose the cameras from the recording, but that's okay.
Eh.
Well, you could double stream it.
Hear us, right?
You could double stream it like Ken's doing. That's fine. But you're muted. Ken's muted in the hangout.
Yeah, Ken and Marcia. Marcia's in the phone.
There we go. Hey, I guess I got the processor power to do both. No reason for me to.
So
if it slows me down, then yeah, I'll turn the Roll 20 off. But until then, I don't really care.
I'm gonna turn it back on. Just mute yourself in Roll 20.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
So let's go explore this ship.
Oh, actually, I'm going to move you guys to the big map here. And where the X is on your map, you figure is going to be down there somewhere.
An X on a map. I do not have an X on my map.
There's not an X. I revealed the piece of the island.
Ah, okay.
Okay, so we're all here.
So let's go to the ship. We're gonna go explore this treasure map. We should do that another day. We started the ship. We should finish the ship.
All right, Marster. I want another fort save from you. This time, get a +2 bonus.
From whom?
Restram. P- pretty plus, terrible.
Plus two, so that's 17.
Oh, yes, yes, it's 17.
Okay, your headache has gotten substantially worse. Your fever has gotten worse. And you are absolutely diseased.
Does he come to, do you come to me about it, or Jask's?
This is after Jask's treatment for a day.
That he hasn't come to me yet.
Well, yeah, because you didn't offer.
I didn't know he has a headache. He hasn't told me. I'm not metagaming this shit.
Redstrom, you take 3 points of intelligence damage.
Well, I mean, so that's pretty meaningless.
What's the diff? It is becoming increasingly difficult to concentrate on things as this overwhelming headache. So that gives you a functional intelligence of 4?
Which means he can no longer read and write.
No, that's 3. 3 is the minimum.
I thought 6 was being able to read and write.
I know 3 is understand language in general.
Yeah, I think 3 is understand language in general, but 6 is read and write.
Oh, well.
I woke up illiterate.
Yeah, so
I've definitely had this
I might days. Be wrong there. It's been a long time since I've looked at those numbers.
I don't know, but yeah, it's going to be a rough day for Redstrom today, guys.
Has he still hasn't come to me to check him out. So.
Well, yeah, it was just a headache. I woke up dumb as a fucking box of rocks.
So. It's not that you're dumb, you just can't. Your head hurts so bad, it's like it's on fire. You just can't concentrate on
okay,
things.
Okay, I'm going to do a health check on him. I noticed he's not feeling fucking right.
Help fight, man.
Help fight, man.
I do a heal check on him to see if I notice anything.
Well, yeah, he's super flushed.
I see that he looks out of shape, and I want to do a heal check.
He has a disease called mind fire. He probably picked that up from a bug bite or something.
Do I know a treatment?
He is going to get over it on his own. He is burning it out right now.
You're going to be fine. You just need to rest.
He doesn't even probably need to rest. He just needs to not, you know.
He just needs to rest.
He doesn't need to take a math test right now.
What? Let me just, if I ask you what 1 + 1 is, just say 2.
Say yes. 1 + 1 is.
Those are numbers.
Okay, let's go take our raft we built and go to that boat.
Ooh, yeah, you get back to the place you stored the raft, and it is totally where you left it.
It's not where we left it, is it?
It is absolutely where you left it. But you can make a survival check.
And see that it was really badly made and we should make another one.
No, this is for something irrelevant. Or not irrelevant, just not relevant to this quality.
I
want to
make
raft.
A check too.
Ooh. Oh man.
Hopefully it doesn't involve numbers.
Oh, wow. It does not involve numbers. Was that 20 Tygon survival check?
My survival check was a 20, yeah.
Alright.
Sergio got a natural 20, so
no, I got a natural
20. Was that me?
Oh yeah, no,
that
sorry.
That was I rolled a 6. That was not me.
Alright.
That was Mr. Dirt for Brains.
You get back to the raft, and it's just covered in like some kind of like a carpet of ants or termites or something, and they're not hostile, they're not like a swarm you need to deal with, but it's a thing.
So that was the perception was just to notice there's ants on it?
Well, like, just to get on the like, not accidentally get on the raft and be covered in bugs.
Can we just kind of just smush them away?
Yep.
Okay.
Not a crisis problem. And we head to the ship.
We head to the ship.
All right, so you woke up. You took 2 hours to get here, and you'll spend another 2 hours just kind of navigating to the island's island.
The island's island.
All right, and this is just a big rocky outcropping. You can try and navigate it close enough to where you can see the name of this ship or any kind of any kind of identifying features of it.
Can we not get onto it?
You could get onto it, yeah. The thing,
are you sure in the process?
The thing is kind of in a bowl where at high tide it could sail in enough to get wedged in, but then at low tide it's up on like a more or less platform so that it's relatively stable. But the ship is, you, when you get close to it, the ship is in pieces. It looks like you would not have been the first people to salvage the ship, actually. There's lots of boards that are cleanly removed, and everything left is dry rotted and unsalvageable for anything better than firewood. And there's lots of big holes and such in it. So let me roll some dice here. But you could get up into the ship, and it does look like it has a more or less in piece structure to where you could get inside it.
Does it look like it would sail?
It does not look like it would ever sail. And you find along the back of it, it has a big plate on it with this name.
Hughes of Grog. Ooh, is there beer on it?
There might be beer on it.
I want to look for alcohol on it.
You guys wanna pilfer?
Priorities.
When we're here, we wasted time getting here. We might as well search what we can get.
Yeah, we gotta go on the ship if it seems tenable at all.
It may have been pilfered, but if there's anything there at all, we need to get it. Even if all we get's really good firewood.
Okay. So the top deck of it looks like it's been stripped pretty hard. There's no bits of metal left. Everything has been taken. Lots of ropes, frays are around. The whole flooring creaks violently, and it feels like that it may go out from under you at any point, but every ginger step you take is on solid ground and nothing bad happens. But this thing, once you're on the deck of it, is nowhere close to being seaworthy, very, very obviously. None of you guys are super sailors, but you can tell. If you go below decks, there's like a big communal cabin area, and there are some, there are some like dried out, like brine weathered, desiccated bodies just kind of strewn about in here.
Oh my God.
They look like they could have been pirates during a more healthy time in their lives.
Does the ship look like it was hit by reavers?
No, because these bodies are in mostly one piece.
Do we find anything worth salvaging at all on the boat anywhere?
I don't know. You start getting to looking for what's good down in the below decks that maybe was overlooked, and these corpses do not appreciate you poking around down here and get up to say hello.
Undead. I can handle undead.
I'm gonna die.
Yeah, no. Undead is not a problem.
Not a problem. Yeah, it's just like, who gets a turn and then... or who gets a turn before Tygon? Nobody.
If I'm person initiative, channel positive energy. You sit down.
You can take the lead on that one, then.
All right, so we're going to do a fight with zombies. Let me grab all these tokens here.
Oh, you're not going to get to use your beach map again.
Yeah, I know, right?
You have to move to a different map.
Also, I did some research because I didn't really know how big ships and galleons were, and they're tiny.
So, initiative?
Yeah.
Eight. Can I roll that again?
Actually.
No valid token was selected. I gotta do it again.
Six.
That's a shame.
Everybody.
Try that again. Oh, it didn't work that time either. Even though that was much better. There we go. Finally sent it. I had to click myself.
Damn it.
Oh, my. Am I rolling again?
Yeah.
You have to click your character. And
well,
then...
you guys rolled initiative before I cleared the old initiatives out, so that's what happened.
It's the same initiative anyway. Like never even happened.
I'm getting pretty quick at things here. All right, so sort, descending, put the round thing at the top. And these zombies are faster than you guys somehow.
Lovely.
It is going to charge forward as a charge action, so it is explicitly charging, and make a slam attack on Sergio.
Ignore that second initiative roll. I'd forgotten to select my icon. Just replace it with what I originally rolled, which was... six.
You're not on the initiative at all.
Well, at the bottom I was, but it went away.
Turn
good.
Six.
Yeah, thank you.
Alright, so it's going to make a slam attack against Sergio. With its... So these things are like... You normally imagine zombies to be like fleshy, bulbous kind of things. These things are withered and desiccated.
So like Scooby-Doo and the Pirate Island type zombie.
He got a 20 to hit for 8 damage.
Oh my god. Yeah, that hits. And 8 damage, okay.
That's smart.
This
takes away 8 of my 20 meager hit points.
This zombie can't... you guys are below deck, so there's not really like a mast or anything, so it's going to charge also... at Tygon. And this is going to be a slam attack at 16 to hit.
My AC is 16.
Ooh, then he hits you. For 7 damage. You guys are surprised by Undalds.
Oh, God.
Turn undead into friends. Alright, so that's his turn. They just wanted to get up and personal in your business. Now, Tygon was the first initiative of the allies, so I guess combat's over.
I want to channel positive energy to hurt undead. Because that's how I do.
Alright, here come will save from left to right. 16.
Do you spell DC?
Yeah, I do. I'm going to tell, I don't know what it is. 16, 5, 20, and 13.
Gotta find where that is. Where is my spell DC?
I don't know.
The DC of this save is equal to 10 plus half the cleric's lever plus the cleric's charisma. So 10 plus 2 plus charisma.
It's 15. Alright, so 2 passes, 2 fails.
Okay, and it's 2d6, I think, right? Yeah, 2d6.
Nice. 10 damage. So the first one passes, he takes 5. The second one fails, he takes 10. The third one passes. And the last one fails. All right, they're all still up. Everybody else is going to get a turn. And you guys can't see their health bars, so let me turn those on.
Technically, we wouldn't know what their health bar is, would we?
I mean, I like to say that you can.
We can see the general health of them.
For
they
some
look bloody. They look beaten.
No, I mean, they are kind of abstract bars. If we're specific numbers, I'd agree more, but... Like, there's... He'd be like, oh, they look pretty close to dead.
Yeah, like, they are falling off of their little bits of bones. That radiant damage did so much that they are just, like... decimated in the literal sense.
Oh, I've got to mark off channel positive energy for that. Marked.
Okay, so that was Tygon's turn. And another zombie. No? Yes?
Wait, what did you do?
I don't know what I did.
I think you skipped two to pew people.
I can't not click this zombie for some reason. There we go.
I think there was Tygon. A zombie. Then, there's a zombie, then Durhood, I think.
I think there's a zombie missing.
Somehow this guy's got removed from the initiative, so let's put him back. I'm pretty sure he was next.
Yeah, I think so.
So he will not be able to charge because there's too many folks in the way, so he will move like. This and stop, and then Restram's up.
No, I think for sure it was Durhood.
No, it's Restram.
No, Durhood's out of the initiative somehow magically.
But Durhood next.
I have an 8 initiative.
Well, then, yes, you should be next.
Okay, I cast Boar Screen on myself.
I'm going fishing.
Rah.
Alright, Restram, look at this whirlwind attack you're being set up for.
I chose my feats poorly. Oh, wait. Am I able to attack with my weapon and shield if it's a full attack?
Yes. Do you have any of the two-weapon fighting bull garbage?
If I you mean, don't, isn't you... that, isn't that baked into the feat?
What feat?
I don't, I got... I have a... Oh, wait. Oh, did I... Yeah, I got a two-weapon fighting.
Yes, you do. Oh, yeah, your thunder and fang baked into the feat. So, yeah, when you full weapon attack, it's... +7, +6.
Nice!
Well, I mean, I might kill one hit. I really don't know what their health is.
I mean, you could step forward and hit two guys.
Well, you can do your first attack and then step forward and then do your second attack. That is also wild. Yeah. And they're at AC penalties because they charged.
Yeah. Dude.
Well, two of them charged.
So that hits that first one at 25.
Yeah, that's a hit.
Do I do less damage?
You do damage because it's one-handed, so it's only 2d6 plus 4 if you're not power attacking. And since you aren't based 2D6 on...
2d6 plus 4, should still knock it on its ass.
It does not knock it on its ass. It is still standing after that. Okay. So
I'll get here. It's
the fang part of it is +6. Which hits, and it's D6 plus 2.
Okay.
which cuts through it pretty clean, and it is enough to destroy it outright. It does so much damage that it hits Sergio. Do you want to do a 5-foot step?
Yeah, actually.
All right, Sergio.
You're muted.
Yeah, keep forgetting that. I was going to attack the guy in front of me, but since he's gone, I guess I'm just going to use my bow and arrow to attack the guy in front of Restram, closest guy.
Okay.
And we'll add a temporary mod of 1 for close range.
Okay.
11. That's after pluses.
11 total?
Yeah, I'm not rolling good tonight. But
that's 11. Not going to hit him. We'll say Restram's in the way.
No, I do have that feat that gives me 2 attacks.
Yeah. Oh, rapid shot. Yay.
Yeah, I'd forgotten I had that the last time, so I'll shoot again.
Now that changes the math for your attack rolls, just so you know.
The second attack, how does that change?
So if you're making your extra attack, it's... Well, so instead of it being... Like, normally it's +8, but then when you make 2 attacks, it's a +6, +6.
I wasn't aware of that. So it takes this -2 for both attacks?
Yeah.
Okay, so then this would be 9 and 19 for those 2 attacks.
19 still is going to hit, though.
Okay, good. Hang on a second. Let me find my bow. There it is. Damage roll. Four damage.
It sinks into it. Doesn't look like it phases it at all.
Okay.
All right, zombies are up. He is done charging. So he will make a slam attack against Tygon again. With a threat!
Ooh.
And confirms on a 7. So you're ready for that. So it's only 8 damage.
Not bad. I can handle. I can take much more than that.
And Tygon can finish the turn.
Seeing that, it gets me a little angry, and I'm like, "Lockify, my god!" And I hold up my symbol high. Channel positive energy. Again. 5 more damage.
All right, saving from left. To bottom left to right. Left gets a 15. Bottom left gets a 5. Right gets a critical fumble.
Does that mean it takes double?
No. But... Alright, so... You destroy both of the ones up front. The last one is still standing.
And I kind of crick my neck. 3 down! 1 to go. And I want to take a step forward.
Okay. Next is going to be Durhood.
I move. And then I take my attacks.
You only get 1.
My attack.
Yeah. you are at, with a single attack... it's a +6.
It didn't roll.
Thirteen is barely gonna hit it.
Is it 1d8 + 2?
It is 1d8 + 3.
Awesome. So 13.
13 damage. Ooh, it is 11. Destroyed utterly.
Yeah.
Just like cleanly chops its head off.
Yeah, and you chop its head off and it still fights for a couple of seconds before it realizes it probably needs that head. And combat over.
And then I want to do 1 quick charge energy to heal us all.
Oh, go for it.
1. Everyone takes 7.
Yay.
Which is funny, because it was one critical fail and one critical heal, so... Yay!
All right, neat.
And then I want to continue searching through shit.
Okay.
Hoping that because the zombies were here, nobody searched through the rest of the ship.
This is going to be so bad. All right, you tear the place apart looking for any kind of treasure. Any kind of anything valuable in here.
Or not just valuable, like compasses, maps, paperwork,
any useful
gear. Firewood. Anything useful. Firewood. Rope. Fishing nets. Arrows. Boats.
You can see that the captain's quarters at the far end of the ship had at one point a very nice lock installed on it that has been smashed open, and inside the room has been turned up already. There are loose coins all over the floor. Everything immediately valuable or useful seems to have been looted already. So,
which means there were survivors.
You can read some records about this being a pirate's vessel, and that there were like mutinous.
So it really is straight up Scooby-Doo.
This was they had just raided a Chalaxian slave ship and were heading to Blood Cove to, spend their newfound fortune. But, you know, the captain is worried about his pirates trying to cut him out of the riches, because he, you know, the captain himself gets 50% of all the booty, and the rest of it is for the minions to squabble over. And he was worried about them mutinizing the ship.
But there's nothing we find of use.
You find 18 gold pieces.
Fuck that.
Which is super valuable here.
Yeah, that's useless on this trip. I tried to get some of the wood chopped it up for some firewood. Start heading back.
Well, okay.
Is anybody else looking going to get anything or anything?
What I think we found all we can from this.
What a letdown.
Yeah, that was a...
Not even perception can save us.
You can make perception checks.
Eventually these things could have come after us, so I'm glad they're gone.
Oh, wait, is it higher now? I think it is. Yeah, add 2 to mine. So I'm 19.
It's a wisdom base, so it's not intelligent, so you're good. Perception is wisdom.
I see all, I know all.
Nope, there's nothing else in here of any value.
Lovely.
Boring.
Maybe we can catch some fish on the way back.
On your raft? Well, I mean, you spent 4 hours traveling. You should probably spend the 4 hours getting back.
Yep.
Sounds like a good plan.
Good, boring plan. All right. You make it back to camp on day 3. No encounters.
I want to do my best not to show how bad our trip went. Seem positive.
It was an experience point.
Well, no, not just that. I don't want the people at camp determining that this was a useless exploration visit.
Let me see. Actually, hold on. Being out on that island, you get a little bit of visibility onto the main island. So we'll put you guys out there, and I'm going to remove some of these clouds. So from that island, you can see the rest of the coast. And you can see that, you know, once you get past that island area, that the beach is kind of treacherous at that point, and you're not saving yourself at all if you're trying to travel along those cliffs. And also, right about, you know, this area is swarming with those pterodactyl critters all up and down the cliffside. It seems to be a big brooding ground for them.
Maybe tomorrow we should head west.
Yep. Tomorrow we should head west, or we should...
Or inland.
Take a party towards the treasure.
Yeah, there's only so much we can move without making temporary camps while we're out. So, I like the idea of hollowing out on each side.
I like the idea of moving more inland and moving everyone as a group. The entire camp moving inland towards that treasure together. Because if we all have to engage in a fight, some of our guys can fight.
Well, not everyone could be in for the treasure. Some people might have other things in mind, you know, so we'd have to definitely talk to people.
Yeah, like survival or getting off the island,
Yeah, I feel like my number one is getting off the island.
Yeah, me too.
The benefit of moving everybody is that you don't need to, you know, travel back here to do stuff. The bad or the negatives are it makes your movement pace significantly slower because some of these people aren't so good at traversing jungle like you guys are. And also, if you're bringing all of your supplies with you every time you move, it makes it grueling.
Maybe we could do a base camp and a couple of light search parties.
And you've gotten the base camp. Pretty much everybody is somewhat self-sufficient at this point. Once they get going, they're not 100%, you know, self-sufficient, but it's getting to the point where you could feel comfortable leaving them alone for a few days.
Yeah. Once we explore west of here and we get to the edge of that and maybe even go inland a bit, it might be time to take multiple day trips away from camp.
Yeah, maybe.
Because having a home base, unless we all have to pick up and move, I kind of like having a home base, but, you know.
Yeah, I mean, you got to find the caves, and then you can move everybody into those.
Get to a point where it would be more beneficial to actually move away from a home base. But right now, having a home base is more beneficial.
Yeah, after the caves, you find the Dharma camp, or the Dharma village.
Yeah.
And then...
I don't get any of these jokes. I've never seen Lost.
Yeah. Well, at least you caught the joke.
Are you frustrated, Perry?
No, I'm fine.
There's a lot of things to find on this island, and a lot of it is red herrings.
Those are delicious, right?
Mm-hmm. I mean, you're catching plenty of them.
Yeah, so far that's all we've found is the red herrings, I think.
Hey, Redstorm, you are cured of Mindfire, but you're going to recover 1 point per day.
Next time I get sick, I want my sickness to be called Mindfire.
You're still a robot.
Still?
Yeah.
Even right now?
Right now.
Yep.
If we get on Overwatch, you'll be fine.
Hey, I should add you on Overwatch.
Oh boy, crew's getting bigger.
Do y'all comp?
Comp?
Nope.
No, I haven't played enough to do that.
That's fine. I'll quick play with you if you want me to.
So, day 3 was pretty letdowny. But let's see.
Am I still robot?
You're good now, I think.
Had at home camp do. I think this is gonna call us for the night after this.
Yeah, this will be at home camp. Sasha has spent the whole day gathering more fruits and vegetables because you can't just eat goats all day. She has made enough food to cover tomorrow. So you will begin day 4 with 3 days worth of food again. Woo!
I just sent a gamer tag to the Google Hangout chat. Just the Gmail chat.
So maybe heading west will be more exciting, or we'll south.
Maybe.
You do have a treasure map that you could start making a beeline toward because treasure is so valuable.
Yeah, it's not really valuable here for this, but maybe eventually. I have a feeling that we're gonna be on this island for months.
Yeah. Eat it.
Well, once
months in real lifetime.
Once, yeah, maybe. Well, we're only playing 2 hours a day, so.
We could go search for the treasure, like the day after we build the boat that'll get us out of here.
Once you get more acclimated to moving about the jungles, you're gonna blaze your own trails. So getting back and forth is gonna become easier. It's just the hard exploration is all front ended. You are in a sandbox and you don't know what direction to go. But then once you get fast travel unlocked, it gets easier.
So we can right now fast travel to that ship, and that's it. And
you can fast travel to that ship, yeah.
That's
right. Do the zombies respawn so we can farm them for XP?
Nope. This is a persistent world. Quest givers only have one quest, and once someone does it ever anywhere, it's done forever.
But that also means we can civilize the island and build a great civilization.
I don't think we have enough genetic diversity.
All dwarves.
Yeah.
We had a gnome, a dwarf, and I think we only have 2 women.
There's pterodactyls on here, and this is D&D. You can breed with anything.
Are there half dwarves?
Yes, they're called mules.
Sexy pterodactyls. Sexy, shocking lizard things. There you go.
Well,
half human and half gnomes. What's that?
I'm gonna send that picture of the reptile again.
Very, very slow progress. So Corey and I don't know if it's Corey or Kush or Kush or Corey, but they watched us play today.
Oh yeah.
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 Marcia can say hello. She knows who these people are.
Hi.
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 Is it still a furry if it's a pterodactyl?
It's a scaly?
Seriously?
Well, pterodactyls had feathers, so... Or did
Never
they?
Never mind, I found a good image.
I don't know. I'm going to stop streaming before we get into a pit. Good night.
Bye.